Hello, I'm Marc Desgroseilliers from Technical Support here at Pix4D, and today I'm talking to you about type points. There are four types of type points in Pix4Dmapper, and I would like to quickly go over them and explain the differences and what they are used for. The first type is the automatic type point. So this is a 3D point, and it's created in the first step of processing, and it's useful for calibrating the images. It allows you to go from the 2D images that you've captured to the 3D reconstruction of the model. And here's an idea of how it works, is that you have your images and you have key points on those images. And once you've identified one key point which appears on several images, if you know the camera position, then you can project these key points. And where these line of projection will meet is where you can create your 3D point. And this 3D point we call an automatic type point. Of course, it's a bit more complicated than this because you need to optimize also the camera position, which a priori you don't know exactly where it is, but this is the idea behind the automatic type point. When you click an automatic type point in the mapper, you will get a few statistics about this type point. For example, the number of images on which it appears. The more images it appears on, the more confidence you can have that it's in the correct place. And also a few statistics about the error around this type point. The second type of type point is the manual type point. Now, this can be very useful because it allows the user to give extra information to the software. Basically, you will be marking the images and you will be telling the software, this feature that I can see on these images, on many images, is actually the same feature. So then this gives information to the mapper because now it knows that when it does the reconstruction, these marks on the images should always project on the same feature. And this can be very useful. For example, if your project has some difficulties in a particular area because the position of the cameras are not exactly correct, then you can create manual type points in this region. You give extra information to the software and this will help it calibrate the cameras. Another scenario where manual type points are useful is in merging projects because of the difference in perspective. So this is what a manual type point looks like in the mapper. And one thing to note is that there is an error associated to the type point. And what you can do is you can click more images, because if you click more images, then the mapper will have more information about this type point, and so it can reduce the error associated to the MTP. The third type of type point I want to talk about is the ground control point, or GCP. Now, we have a complete video dedicated just to GCPs and georeference. So if you're interested in this topic, I encourage you to have a look. But quickly, I mean, GCPs are points in your project which you measured the coordinates of with a precise GPS device. And they allow you to have accurate absolute geolocation and also to reduce the error in your project. The last type of type point is the checkpoint. The checkpoint is very similar to the GCP. So it will have measured coordinates that you acquired on the field. You will also need to mark it in the images. The main difference between the GCP and the checkpoint is that the checkpoint is used for accuracy. Accuracy check, that is. So what do I mean by this? When you create a GCP, you're providing extra information to the mapper, and the mapper will use this information during the optimization procedure to make sure that the model is reconstructed correctly. With the checkpoint, the mapper will ignore this information. And so what this does is that it gives you a way to assess the accuracy of the project in an unbiased way. because the this information was not taken into account, so the mapper didn't try to precisely fit the checkpoint to the position that it should be. And so this gives you a way to say if the project is well reconstructed in this area. When you add GCPs or checkpoints, there will be a table that is generated in the quality report. And this table displays the error in the X, Y, and Z directions. What do I mean by error? It's going to be the difference between the input coordinates, the ones that you measured on the field, and the coordinates that the mapper has assigned to the checkpoint or the GCP. So this gives you a way to assess if the reconstruction has gone well. And there will also be a couple of statistics that are generated on these numbers. So the mean, the variance, and also the RMS error. Okay, so I went over all the four tie points that are present in Pix4Dmapper. Let's go and see in the software how it looks like when you want to actually add an MTP in your project. Let's see how to add a manual tie point. So the first thing to do is to find in the project where you want to add the tie point. Let's say that I would like to add it here, maybe. That looks like it's the edge of a building. There you go. So now I click the point in the rayCloud and the images appear on the right. I can select here, add new tie point. Great. I will call it my tie point. And I can choose the type of tie point as we discussed earlier. So there is a 3D GCP, 2D GCP where you would have just the X and Y coordinates, manual tie points, and checkpoint. If you choose 3D GCP, as you see here, you can input the X, Y, Z coordinates that were recorded for the GCP. But let me add a manual tie point. So I cannot enter these fields anymore because manual tie points don't have coordinates. Now I can click it on the images. So I go on the image, I make sure that I click exactly the feature that I'm interested in. Note that the mapper takes into account the zoom level. The more zoomed in on the image, the more weight this click will have. If you are not sure where to click exactly, it's better to zoom out, and then this click has less weight when the mapper optimizes. So I can click on a few images, make sure that I always click the right point, and there you go. Now I click apply. The mapper is going to create the 3D point according to the marks on the images. And as you can see here, maybe I need a little bit more work. Here, I can look at the reprojection on the different images, make sure that it's okay. I click apply. And then I'm done with this tie point. Maybe I would add other tie points, but then to make sure that they are taken into account in the optimization and the camera positions, I would need to do process and then re-optimize. So that's all we wanted to discuss today about tie points. So we hope that this has been helpful and we'll see you in the next video.